Please welcome Betty Boo.
Come and join us, Betty.
Where's my sit?
Betty Boo, yeah. She was quite sexy, weren't she?
And quite a babe.
Everyone loves Betty Boo. Everybody needs a bit of Betty Boo in their life.
Definitely do it if I had a chance.
I've had enough of this.
I'm off.
Oh. Hey, Betty Boo. Betty Boo just
doing the do when you are through. And there's nothing... 1990s pop minx Betty Boo started life as Alison Clarkson before a resemblance to a cartoon character was to change her life forever.
When I was at school, I kept changing my hairstyles and one day I just got it cut really short like a crop. And people used to say I look like Betty Boo. But I look nothing like her at all. It's stupid, really. Just stuck.
Betty's education was as much street as it was school, which gave her an early foothold in the London hip-hop community.
I used to go tagging with my brother and loads of people from Ladbroke Grove. And we used to go down the yards and spray late at night. My tag was Alley Cat. I'm a bit of a cat.
Betty and her mates formed the She Rockers posse, and before long she was singled out as a rising star of British rap.
Certain record companies heard about us, and the Beatmasters were asking for, they wanted me to do like a guest vocal on their song. How dare you ever care to play that trash? You better prepare to go away, no more tit for tat, yeah, cause I can dance for that. Beatmaster song, that was my stepping stone into it. And they gave me a deal, they gave me a little bit of money, and I bought some equipment, musical equipment, and I set it up in my bedroom at home.
But she had to make the best of a bad lot when seeking musical influences.
We didn't have many records at home. My dad had a Wombles record, and I was inspired by it, by the melodies of it all. I just tried to analyse it a little bit.
Hello? Hello, hello, hello. Hooglum, that's why you call me rebellious. You can't ignore me, but never mind, cos I know that I'm sweeter. Your time is up to put my money in your meter. You say I bully, though I know...
When I wrote that song, I was really, really angry with the way my teachers treated me at school. I told my careers officer that I wanted to be a vet. Cos I liked animals, you know, little furry kittens. And she said, oh, I think you've got ideas above your station. So I really wanted to say something about them because teach the crap.
Betty Boo, what a dream. And I think she did one of the great, great records of the 90s, doing the do. You know, 10 years on, it's still an incredibly memorable record, and it has got great lyrics, even if she doesn't know what they mean.
Now, doing the do, right? Although it was a hip-hop term, meaning that you're sort of in control of your career and or whatever, it also means cunnilingus.
Betty Boo made a brilliant pop record though, Where Are You Baby? That was just such a perfect pop moment. It's that. It's lightweight and admitting you're lightweight and saying, fuck you, I'm lightweight, but I'm good at it, you know.
Betty Boo, who seemed to be enormous for a while, and she had two really good songs and she was everywhere, she was front covers everywhere and everybody loved her, the kids loved her, the boys loved her, and then she just disappeared.
So I was working really hard and, you know, for a young girl it was a bit too much really. I had to take a little bit of time out because I was exhausted, I was quite ill from working. I had had a boil on my bum once, that was quite funny. I had to go get it lanced with my silver shorts in Amsterdam.
Arse trouble behind her, Betty resurfaced in 93 with second album, Grr, It's Betty Boo. And although she failed to scale previous heights, she was still attracting all the right sort of attention.
I mean, all these other record companies are trying to get hold of me as well, like Madonna's label. And I got a phone call from Madonna when I was in New York. We talked about doing a deal together. But then my mum fell sick, she had cancer, and I decided not to, to make music. I just couldn't, I just wanted to be with her in hospital. So after that, I couldn't be bothered. I've taken about 5 years out now, and I'm songwriting for other bands. Got a song coming out with Louise, I wrote and produced that. I was working with a girl band, but they're called Girl Thing. You know, I'm just behind the scenes now, and I quite enjoy it.
I would love to sit down with Betty Boo and say to her, so Betty, would you redo it all over again? I mean, what did she say?
I mean, I might make another record, but I don't know. Meow.